Hey everybody, and welcome back. If you haven't been here before, my name is Mary. Now today I'm going to talk about the only book I reread the last year, 2021, on Kindle Unlimited. Now this is just Kindle Unlimited. I do have a lot of physical books on my shelf that I did reread, but for all the books that I read on Kindle Unlimited, there was only one series, that it was a two-book series, that I went back and read. I started thinking about it one day. I had read something that kind of reminded me of it, and I thought, I want to read it again. I really do. And the reason I went back and reread this was because of all the emotion that it brought out in me. Now, this is dark, dark romance, almost black, okay? This is the Torment, it's Torment 1 and 2, the Burning Heart series by Dylan Page. Now, this, again, trigger. Not for everybody. Definitely not. Again, it just, it's got age gap, MC romance, but the MC rom, I wouldn't call this a romance, more of a psychological thriller type. I mean, it deals with mental illness, so don't think I'd categorize it so much, maybe dark romance, but it's taboo, it's age gap, I mean, it's dark. It revolves around Shay and Mina. Now, Shay and Mina's parents get married. Now, Mina's mother doesn't know what she's getting into with Shay and his dad. When she was dating his dad, she had no idea he was in a motorcycle club, a one percenter, very bad club. And by the time she figured it out, it was way too late. They wouldn't let her leave. So basically she had to get married to this guy. Shay took a very unhealthy interest in Mina. And again, she was only 7 when the book started. Now, it's not, I wouldn't go to say it's pedophilia. It's not quite that, because he doesn't really do anything outward toward her until till she's older. But he takes that unhealthy interest in her from the time she is 7. He becomes obsessed with her. She was the only person that he felt was ever really nice to him. It's hard to explain without giving away spoilers. But needless to say, it didn't go well for Mina. Shay would never hurt her, so I don't want to say Shay, not in the physical sense, he would not. But mentally, oh dear. Shay was one messed up. I mean, messed up guy. He had mental illness that you'll learn in the book that his dad knew he had but didn't really take care of. So that's what this book revolves around. And then you have Mina's love interest in the book, which is Keenan. But this series, I'm telling you, it just made me feel. And again, when you have such a horrible person as Shay in the book, such a horrible main male character, it's very hard to evoke an emotion of understanding and even pity for someone like Shay. This author did it. I don't know how Dylan Page did it, but at the end of book 2, I'm telling you, I understood and even felt pity for him. Now, did I really like Shay? I wouldn't go that far, because again, he had done some really, really horrible stuff throughout the book. But being able to understand him and even pity him was quite a feat. And if you read the books or you read the books, you know what I'm talking about. But I'm telling you, it stuck with me. Even now, I sit here and I think about it, you know, how much I really, and for a dark, dark, almost black romance, I really, really enjoyed this. I love the writing style of how she wrote the books out. Again, I loved how I was able to kind of feel what was going on, you know, because again, the one thing I'm finding with Kindle Unlimited, especially, you know, in any genre on there, is that I just don't get that emotional attachment to any of the main characters. It's, you know, nobody character builds. So it's really hard for me to get attached or even interested to the point of feeling any emotion. But with this series, I did. And again, not for everybody. Lots and lots of triggers. And I'm not joking here. These are triggers. I wouldn't even deem it romance. Let's go with that. But for me, my only reread last year, there's lots of books I want to reread. So I don't want to say there's not. I found a lot that I loved, but there was only, this series was the only one that I downloaded again and reread, and will I'll read it again. It just had that, brought that kind of feeling out in me, that, you know, that emotion, attachment to the characters that you get long after you've read. And so, yeah, I'll be back to read. There's actually a third book called Ashes, I believe, that just came out not too long ago. But it deals with, it's a little different, still good, but it has a whole different feel to it than what these two books did. Because again, you know, the dynamic between Shay, Meenan, and Kenan, and then Shay's dad and Mina's mom and everything that happened. And again, I'm not going to give away any spoilers, but if you like dark romance and you don't have any triggers, and you like to read anything and you can handle it, this series is a very, very good one. Again, I'd say, you know, if you like MC romance, maybe, but really that kind of took a backseat to what was happening between Shay and Meena, so, and Kenan. So, but again, really drew me in emotionally, kept me interested. I'm still attached to Shay, Meena, and Kenan. Very hard to do with me. So that was why that was my reread, only one for Kindle Unlimited last year. So I just wanted to talk about that today. And in case somebody else loves really dark romance, if you do, the series one's for you. I'm telling you, it's very, very good. So with that, I'm going to go. But until I see you guys next time, you know, hey, happy reading.